Hello. In this video on digitization, I want to make clear that information and communication technologies, ICT, will increasingly play a role in the transport system. ICT makes traveling easier. It sometimes provides alternative for travel, such as in case of e-shopping, but it also generates new travel. For example, if a person meets new friends electronically and she wants to visit them. Next, I aim to make clear that there is only a limited role for public policies in the area of digitization. I will firstly discuss the impact of ICT on the transport system. ICT will make traveling easier. Satellite navigation already makes it easier to find your route. And thanks to ICT, so-called road authorities guide people, for example, in case of a roadblock due to an accident. Due to websites and via smart apps nowadays, it is easy to find out how to travel using public transport, not only before, but also during the trip. Smart apps also make it easier to find a carpool match or to order a taxi, either conventional or new forms like Uber. And being online while traveling by train makes train trips more attractive. Secondly, ICT increasingly is an alternative for travel. An increasing share of the people have office jobs, and many people in such jobs can telework, at least in some cases. And people can shop online, Skype, communicate via WhatsApp, game online, and join the benefits of e-learning, e-conferencing, etc. So we do not always need to have physical access to destinations to do the activities we want to do, but increasingly we can do those online. Thirdly, ICT is not only a substitute for travel, but it also generates new activities and travel. For example, we might have met friends electronically, which we want to see in person someday. Another example, sometimes universities look for a new PhD student, a student who will do research for several years after she received a master's degree in order to get a PhD. Nowadays, it is very easy to Skype with people all over the world so that they do not have to travel all the way to a university for a job interview. So ICT substitutes travel. But because Skyping is so easy, the chance that a person for example, Iran or China gets a job in the USA is much higher than before. And that person might visit family and friends several times during her research. This generates new travel. ICT will also influence the production and distribution of goods. It already does, because thanks to ICT, companies and even private persons can easily explore options to buy and sell goods worldwide. In the future, 3D printing might fuel a revolution in at least some markets. Finally, I want to make clear that ICT can be a painkiller. Thanks to ICT, we are less vulnerable in case of disruptions in the transport system. If, for example, there is a train strike or roadblock, many people can still work from home, online, making societies less vulnerable for such disruptions. What should governments in general, or at the city level in particular, do about ICT? ICT policies in general are certainly important, but this applies less to specific policies related to the transport system. So the answer, as far as the urban transport system concerns, that this is mainly the area of companies, the so-called private sector. Governments can set the rules for such companies, for example, related to privacy, and to avoid large companies becoming monopolies. An important exception relates to autonomous vehicles. They can have a big influence on urban transport, not only because of their impacts on safety and traffic flow, but also because they might change travel and activity behavior. For example, no driver's license is needed anymore, and thus everybody can drive. And because driving is so easy, we might decide to work, recreate, or do other activities at different places and maybe even more frequently. Governments certainly set the rules and decide upon which vehicles are allowed to drive autonomously, where and when. To wrap up, ICT in infrastructure can generate more efficient traffic flows and navigations, both with and without a system of autonomous vehicles. ICT for services can provide travel information such as for public transport, can support carpooling, and ease ordering a taxi, conventional, Uber, or other people. And being online in public transport makes traveling more attractive. What then is the role of ICT for sustainability? I think that thanks to ICT, we can still do many activities, even if we would run out of cheap oil, or if traveling becomes expensive due to climate change policies.